What's up, people? I'm trying to get Jimmy Ludds to come on live with me. Should kids go back to school? Absolutely. What am I drinking tonight? Coffee. Where's Jimmy Ludds? We're trying to get Jimmy Ludds to go live. I think I have a hernia right now. We're going. What's up, conservative Cuban? See, Quinn, I accepted your invitation to go live. The fuck's wrong with you, pussy? Conservative Cuban, I'm turning Smoking the Bandit on right now. We ain't got time for no hush puppies. When I get home, I'm gonna punch your mama in the mouth, because you are not from my loins. Look, Daddy, a football game. Can we stay and watch? Testing Debo for a first cycle is a bad idea. Some bitch. Who's chasing you? Nobody's chasing me, boy. Give me a Diablo sandwich and a Dr. Pepper. Big Rob made a video about me. Get Big Rob to go live right now. Jay, accept my request. Darcy. Okay.
Big Dave from Canada.
What's up?
We're not all pussies over here. I think like you do, Trump dude. All these protests and pussies going, oh, all cops are bad. No, not all cops are bad. You play stupid games, you win stupid prizes. You know what
What?
I mean? Fuck. All these little fucking Antifa faggots with their little skateboards.
Oh.
Oh, Black Lives Matter. You know what I mean? They're little skateboard gothic kids. Their moms come out chasing them, chase them out because they left the stove on cooking their fucking hot pockets. Little cocksuckers. I'm drinking their pops too, eh? How you doing, Big J? Been following you for a while, bro. Can you see me okay or what? I got the yellow plaid. I got a new plaid on. Like the killer, that's the murder hornet. That's the next fucking after the coronavirus and the fucking and all these protests, the murder hornets are coming on. You know? How you doing, Jay?
I'm doing good.
Fucking rates, man. Where you at?
I'm in,
What?
Fuck.
I'm in Canada, right? So.
Forget where I am. I'm so drunk.
At least you're in the passengers. Attaboy. Yeah. No, I grew up from a family full of truckers, right? We do a lot of oil field work up here in northern Canada. So I grew up a lot in the oil patch and shit, right? So
oil patch.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Alberta. You know where Alberta is?
Nah.
Northern BC. Like, it's in Canada. But, you know.
Wayne Gretzky from Alberta?
He cut from the same cloth we are. Trust. Wayne Gretzky, he can't get. He was a legend, right? But I mean, only the legend because he never got hit. When he got hit, he wasn't a legend no more. No, I wasn't a big. I grew up in Edmonton, right? Where he played for. He grew up in Ontario, though, him, eh? I don't like the finesse players, man. I'm a Boston or Philly fan. I like hard players, right? Like, I was a Proby fan. Bob Probert,
yeah.
Back in the day. Oh, Proby before he passed away? Oh, yeah. And then,
Windsor, Ontario, right?
Yeah, he's from Windsor, yeah. I was born in London, just above there. Right? So. But I grew up on the West Coast out here, right? I grew up in the oil patch, so. I'm in Vancouver now. I've been out here back and forth 15 years, right? I tear down big buildings now, so. Commercial demo for me? Drop them, boys! Get the fucking, drop them! Get the jackhammers going, get the big high reach going. I'm going to go out for a smoke, though. You'll still be able to see me here, brother.
Wow.
Huh? Fuck, I'll smoke in here. I'll smoke. I'm not supposed to smoke in here, but fuck it, I'll do it. Yeah, no, Proby, like, I don't like the finesse players, right? I was never a Gretzky fan. Like, when I was a little kid, obviously, because he was from, you know, he was from the city that I grew up in. And fucking, yeah, but he just, you know, I don't like that shit. I don't like those little finesse, I like the rugged fuckers, right? Gotta drop the gloves, like, fuck the Broad Street Bullies, you know, Philly, or fucking Bruins. Back in the day, I don't like these, I don't like the Dipsy Doodle and shit. But yeah, the great one put everybody on the map, right? But,
what about Gordie Howe? He didn't have any goons.
Oh, Howe, yeah, Howe was fucking, yeah, but he was a Red Wing, though. He was a Red Wing. Yeah, he's fucking Howe. Gordie Howe was better than Gretzky.
Bobby Hall.
They're like, oh, no, the great one's better.
Did you just say
Bobby Hall? Oh, yeah, fucking right he did. He did it with shittier equipment, too. Just Gretzky just was always protected. Gordie Howe would fucking... Gordie Howe would get in there and get dirty. Huh?
You said Bobby Hall.
Bobby Orr. Bobby Hall's good, too, yeah. All those guys, those are the guys that are made men.
Bobby Orr.
Gretzky would never go into the corner by himself, right? He would never go into the corner.
If you got guns around you, you shouldn't go in the corner.
Oh, you didn't have really that many goons. He got fucking... No, it was just a different game back then, too, right? It was just like, oh, nobody touches him.
Yeah, but
bias about, shit, right?
What about Bobby Hall? Brett Hall's father.
Yeah, I know who Bobby Hall is. Where do you play for, the Flyers? Did he play for Flyers or what? Like, I'm not a hockey fan. I'm a football fan, right? Mostly or old school hockey, but not that old. I'm only 39, right? So, I'm not only. Like, I'm getting pretty old, but those are my teams, right? Yeah, Bobby Hall, I don't really know too much about him, but Gordie Howe. Gordie Howe was the first Gretzky, but he got his hands too. Yeah, Gretzky no doubt was good. He was definitely good, right? But It was just kind of like he had a don't touch me sign on him, you know? Back then. He didn't scrap. He never fucking, you know?
That's why
I like guys that get Hall. Down. Huh?
Bobby Hall.
Yeah, I was asking you. Was Bobby Hall the Flyer? Not Bobby Clark I'm thinking of.
He was Brett Hall's father.
I don't know. Yeah, I know Brett Hall, though. He played for Dallas for years, right?
Brett
played
Hall
for St. Louis.
Incredible Red Wing.
Yeah.
At the end of his...
Yeah, well, he played there, too. You know, but Brett Hall played for the Dallas Stars, and he played for St. Louis Blues for years.
Badass name.
Yeah, played for Philly, though, right? I'm asking you, did you play for Philly?
I don't even know.
That was a little bit before my time. Huh?
I don't know. I'm not a Philly fan.
Yeah, I like Proby. Proby's my favorite. All time. Fucking, I like the Scrappers, right? And he had good hands. He could score goals. Fucking get, you know, fucking get assists. He could play the puck, but he could drop it, too. He could drop the gloves. People were scared of him. You know?
Yeah, back in the 90s, it was all Red Wings, Bruce Brothers.
Oh, yeah, Red Wings. Yeah, they had Sergei Fedorov. They had fucking Chelios. Yeah, it was Chelios. Chelios before he went to fucking Chicago.
Joey Koser.
Koser, yeah, like fuck when Bobby was on the fucking ice, Bobby was the main man. He was their second tough guy, but Bob Proby was the man. Proby dummy everybody on there. Yeah, Koser was good though. He was a good scrapper. But he was on the different line though on Proby. Proby was the man. Like fucking, yeah, Joey Koser, yeah, he used to fucking, yeah, throw it down. Proby was the fucking, he was the man.
Yeah.
I like because he had a bad background too, eh? Like the party a bit, wrecked bikes. Remember when he got banned, he couldn't play in Canada? Cocaine. Huh?
Because of cocaine.
Yeah, he got pulled over and he had it in his shirt and they caught him and everything.
Hold on.
Probably can give
BJ
a few fucks.
BJ has a piss. So, are you old enough to remember when...
What were you...
The Red Wings put out the Russian Five.
Well, just because I'm from Canada, I'm not big on like all hockey trivia. I just like the Scrappers. I like a lot of the American teams more, right? Like Proby was a fucking, yeah, he played for the Spitfires, Windsor Spitfires. You know, that's where he came from, but that's the OHL, right? Before he got drafted. And he bounced around and shit like that, but no, I like the old school fucking players, right?
You like
Philly back
players,
in the day.
You don't know who Bobby Hall is.
I know who Bobby Hall is. He played for Philly. I'm sure he did. He had the curly red hair.
Yes.
Yeah. But that's before my time too. Like
I think he was in Alberta.
Well, we're all farmers up here. We grew up on tractors, not here. I'm in Vancouver now. A lot of these people, they wear the big sunglasses and they got the little dogs in their purse. They all think they're movie stars. But when the shit hits the fan, though, they won't be able to handle fuck all.
You go back to the
fucking millennial.
Bobby Hall looked like a bodybuilder from Balen Hay.
Yeah, well, you know. Gotta be Proby was not big. Proby would dummy him. Proby would foul him. I used to have his book. Yeah, I lost it somewhere, but I fucking had a couple of years. Read it three times over, man. Proby was a wild child, bro. He was fucking drinking Clint Eastwood right now from Gran Torino. What you doing, you little zipper heads? Don't piss me off, you little zipper heads. Remember you sitting on the porch? You ever watch that movie?
Gran Torino is when one of my Bibles.
Huh?
Gran Torino is one of my Bibles.
Oh, yeah, I love. But he was sitting on the porch like this. Old man, eh? Drinking the pops. What are you doing, you little zipper heads? Don't piss me off. If you're lucky, punk.
You're mixing up the movies.
No, all clear, he's ready.
You're mixing up the movies.
No, I know that. That was a different one. That was Dirty Harry in the Deadpool, eh? When he pulled out that 44, 45. If you're lucky, punk, do ya? No, I'm talking about the zipper heads.
Zipper
heads. Fucking zipper heads. Oh, you should hear see all these butt fucking hurt people up here for all these, like, oh, Black Lives Matter. Every life fucking matters. You know what I mean? But you don't hear about when there's a white cop that gets shot or, like, a white person gets shot in a crossfire. You know what I mean? And that's the Blue Lives Matter. And my buddy sent me this video. He goes, oh, look at this. This is police brutality. This is in Edmonton. It was on YouTube. I'm like, that's not fucking police brutality. I said, I didn't watch the whole video. They weren't dummy in them. But if it takes that many people, that many cops, pin them down, and they're not laying the boots to the guy either. But you got to understand, too, I told them, too. I said, hey, all these guys think all cops are bad now. They're not all bad. And there's bad apples everywhere. You could be a bad apple just crossing the street. Don't mean nothing. So, of course, they're on edge. So they're not going to take any fucking, you know. No, I say Blue Lives Matter, man.
Some of my best friends
fucking
are police officers.
Told the line, I say.
I'm very...
Oh, yeah, any time I've ever been in trouble in my life, it was only because I deserved it, Jay. But it was a lot easier when I was younger, like when I did get in trouble, just for bar fights and shit, right? It was yes, sir, no, sir. There was no fucking millennials like, now I know my rights with the camera on. You don't know fuck all. You know what I mean? And now all these guys are trying to push the envelope, push the boundaries.
Hey,
you grew up my day.
I got a good story for you, if you can shut up for a second.
I know. I'm a talker. I'm drinking, though. Sorry, man.
I was at a bar in Windsor, Ontario, when I was 19 years
old. Yeah.
And I got some cocaine in the bathroom. And
yeah.
I'm 19 years old, and
That happens,
I go
especially
outside,
back then. Yeah,
and I said something stupid about Canadians, which I wish I could take back.
Yeah, we're not all bad, man. Like I should be born in Texas. All my buddies say, "Fuck you, belong in Texas."
Story, brother.
You're such a right wing. Huh?
I walk outside of the bar, high on cocaine. I'm like 19 years old. And me and this Canadian guy, this roughneck guy, I don't know, he must have been a bricklayer or a carpenter or something. He was a tough guy. And so him and I start trading fists to the face. And we're having a pretty good fight going on. And I see the police roll up on the fucking street, and I say to the guy that I'm in the middle of this fight. I'm like, "Hey, man, the cops are here. We gotta stop this shit." And my Canadian.
No, he wasn't that tough. Hey, he wasn't that tough. Hey,
right.
If he didn't end it, he ain't that. Where? Oh, up here, no, too. There's. He ain't that tough, eh? I say, carpenter. I call them carpenters. Like little packies. Carpenters. He ain't that tough.
No, but
and you fucking throttle him.
This Canadian guy that I was fighting in Windsor, Ontario, as soon as I told him...
Yeah, but he wasn't that tough, eh?
The cops were on the scene. Him and I stood up from wrestling on the ground, punching each other, and we shook hands. And we walked away because the police were there. It was like,
well, you screwed. Yeah, I mean, you should. One of you guys should have ended it first, eh? Before cops come there.
A couple of white
guys. Usually, fucking.
A couple of white guys just trading knuckles. We're not getting arrested.
No, bro.
Fuck that.
Chucking mitts, man. Throwing hands.
Right.
No, but even that tough though. He didn't represent. You know, not all Canadians are pussies, right? Like I'm Canadian, right? Born and raised. But I love Trump, man. I'm a huge Trump follower.
That's good.
And all these weak people. Like, oh yeah, Trump's a fucking Trump is a dummy sometimes though. When he tweets on Twitter, sometimes he's like a little kid. But I love it. I love it watching him. It's like me when I'm bored. I troll, right? And Trump's got so much power. And he says some stupid shit sometimes, but it's real. It's true.
Yeah.
It's fucking funny. But then all these fucking sensitive little bitches, though, they get all like, oh, fuck. Fuck that. Trump, fucking, I want Trump again. We got a pussy up here for a fucking prime minister. We got a prime minister. You guys have a president? We got a our top guy is prime minister of the Canada. Justin Trudeau. Yeah, Trump wouldn't even look at him anymore. Trump tried to like him in the beginning.
Biden.
He wanted fuck. He's such a pussy. Oh yeah, Trudeau's a fucking little clown. I don't care anyways. I'm not really a government guy. I think that you don't have to like have a guy in office to make your life better. You just work harder. You know what I mean? I could have the shittiest. Like I have Trudeau in there. I got a pretty good life. He doesn't dictate it. He just makes the fucking shitty rules and shit. But I don't got to play by him. I just got to kind of stay in the boundary. You know what I mean? Just don't act like a shithead and work. All these people are like, oh, we need a better prime minister. Well, if you're praying on a prime minister, you're probably on fucking welfare. You know, you have no gumption. You know what I mean? Like, fucking everybody can make their own fucking way.
Suck.
All right, bro. But he doesn't justify what I do. I can make as much money as I want, live a good life as much as I want. You know? All these fucking weak motherfuckers. Everybody's like, oh, Obama. Obama had the Obamacare. Since Trump came in there, way more fucking jobs. Way more. You know what I mean?
Oil and natural
gas. He's kind of fucked with Canada a bit, though. Like, but whatever. But that doesn't affect me. I love Trump over Trudeau. It doesn't affect me. When he's like, nope, we're not giving them no masks. We're getting them all the 3M fucking... Like, that was on the news. And everybody's like, what? Nobody's getting masks? I've never worn a mask fucking one time. I don't even know anybody that knows anybody that knows anybody that had coronavirus. But yet they want to shut everything down, right? I don't care, whatever. Fuck.
Okay. Good talk.
No, I like Trump. What's that, Jay? Jay? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm pro-Trump, man. Now Kanye West is going to try to run? Oh, no.
They call you bully.
Why is it that I hear myself? Jay, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, now Okay, now everything's normal. For some goddamn reason, I was hearing myself. You know, a conversation goes two ways. You may speak whenever freely.
Daddy, look, a football game.
There it is, Jay. Told you I was playing in the background. They just pulled up. They're picking up the cores over in Texas right now.
Man, I want to suck Sally Field's toes.
Dry, or would you pour something on them?
No, dry.
Yeah. Oh, man.
These are dancers' legs. And then Bert says, Cowboys love fat calves. Love
fat calves. Oh, man. Jay, did you were you ever a fan of the movie that Burt Reynolds was in also? It was kind of like a, I don't want to say it was like a true story or anything like that, but it was based on the famous stuntman Hooper. Did you ever see the movie Hooper?
Of course I've seen Hooper.
Remember that bar scene when they run into what's his name? Terry Bradshaw?
Bradshaw was in a lot of Burt Reynolds movies.
Yeah, he was in one of the Cannonball Run movies. That's right.
Yeah.
Remember that scene? He's like, he's looking at Bradshaw. He's looking at all the other guys, and he's counting. He said, yeah, you're going to have to go get about six more. And he punches him, spits out a tooth, and smiles. And we might be in trouble. That's awesome. You're a Burt Reynolds fan. Holy shit.
Yep. Yeah, I like I like Trans Ams and Pontiacs. All of Burt Reynolds movies had Pontiacs in them.
Yeah, and Hooper, they had like a, I want to say, I think it was a red Firebird, didn't they? That they strapped rockets onto or something?
Yeah, that's a Pontiac.
Yep. Oh, man.
Yeah. Even but when my, you go way back to White Lightning.
Oh, wow.
That's where Gator started, was White Lightning, right?
I don't know. I don't remember. What the fuck do I know?
The Gator character, I think, started out with in White Lightning.
The Gator character. Isn't that Jan Michael Vincent?
No, Gator is Burt Reynolds. Jan Michael Vincent might have been in the movie. Gator, dude.
Like to calm down, light the cigarette, gather yourself, gather your thoughts, relax, everything's fine. I'll take another swig of the beer. Oh, we need cigarettes.
I just remember that one scene from, I think it was Gator, where the husband was sleeping and Burt Reynolds goes off the dock and goes swimming. And the wife goes out there and Gator's, Burt Reynolds is swimming in the lake and she offers him some shaky pudding. What she means by shaky pudding is pussy.
Not her toes.
No, shaky pudding is pussy. Come on, yeah, Gator. Don't you want some of this shaky pudding?
Oh, man. You know, growing up here in South Florida, there were times I would drive out. Well, not myself. I would be out with family. And we would have at least more than one family member that would live out in Jupiter. And we would always go down that road. And you would always see Burt Reynolds Ranch. You would see, which I thought it was BS until I actually saw it. He had... I don't want to say he had the truck out there, but he definitely had the trailer that had the scene on the side where there's an outlaw robbing a stagecoach. And I remember seeing that all the time. I don't think it's no longer there anymore.
So where do you live nowadays?
Right now, I live in the murder capital of the world. I live in Riviera Beach.
Then why haven't you come down to see the Misfits in real life?
Oh, Jay, I'm shy. Plus, I went last that long. Jay, you and I, you got to understand something. You and I coming together, it'd be like two tectonic plates. We'd probably end up getting arrested, stealing a 10-speed, who knows?
Why, do you have cocaine?
No cocaine.
As long as you don't have cocaine, I'm not winding up in jail.
Well, you know what? The next time you're back down here, which I'd probably be a few months, who knows? Last time you were out, you were like out, gone for 6 months.
I'm coming but back for Labor Day weekend.
And then we're going to have to set something up.
Why don't you come out to Bradford Estates?
Well, you're inviting me to Bradford Estates, and Bradford has to have a say in this, doesn't he?
Dude, I've known you for a while. I can vouch for you.
That's very, very kind of you. I look forward to Bradford calling me a faggot.
Now, let me talk about your name. You're the conservative Cuban.
You know, this is what happened, Jay.
No, let me give some background to these assholes that don't understand history. I know about the Bay of Pigs and John F. Kennedy, who is a Democrat, who fucking failed to provide air cover to the fucking rebels, that he promised air cover, and all those good men that were there to overthrow Castro died on the beach. I know why most Southern Florida Cubans vote Republican for the rest of their lives. It's because of John F. Kennedy leaving those good men to die on the beach at the Bay of Pigs. So don't fuck with me. I know my history.
And you know, Jay, it goes even further than that. When you, even right now, you and I, we could go visit a retirement community where all these Cubans are out there smoking cigars, they're drinking coffee, playing dominoes all day. And pretty much the basis of their conversations, it goes to Kennedy. They'll talk about Carter. They'll talk about Clinton. They'll talk about Obama. And pretty much the debate is over which one's the communist and which one's the faggot. So it goes beyond Kennedy because they're keeping their eye on everyone. Yeah. And it doesn't matter how many of these old Cubans die out, there's still another one to take their place or two. So
you know what I like about Cubans? They're proud fucking Americans. They might be proud Cubans, but they're the best proud Americans of any Latino group I can point at.
You know, Jay, my dad's dad, you want to know what his favorite American movie was?
Probably Clint Eastwood.
Oh, my God. Heartbreak Ridge. That was my grandfather's favorite American movie was Heartbreak Ridge. And you
I
should.
I wish I was taller. I could be Big Swede.
Oh my God. Don't go away. Just go away. Oh man.
I love Clint Eastwood.
I love that movie, Heartbreak Ridge. I love it because my grandfather. I can still remember the song playing in the beginning of that movie, "The Sea of Heartbreak." It's a country song.
You know what my favorite Clint Eastwood movie is? Million Dollar Baby.
Wow.
Oh my God.
Wow.
That movie makes me cry. And I'm not afraid to cry because I'm a big man. Make fun of me crying, I'll punch your face.
That movie's deep on so many levels because the character that he played and the character that Hilary Swank played, it almost ended up being like a father-daughter relationship that he was reluctant to do. He didn't want to train her. He didn't want to have anything to do with that. And at the end, it's almost like, damn, man, this weight that he's got to carry now. How are you that?
Two-time Academy Award winner.
She killed it in that movie. She killed it. And so did he.
Yeah. Million Dollar Baby and Gran Torino are my two favorite movies. Period. Not up for discussion.
Do you remember what was the very first Clint Eastwood movie you ever saw?
It's probably a spaghetti western.
Yeah, a fistful of dollars.
Hold on, I gotta piss. I'm drunk.
And we still love you, Jay. Look, Jay, I'm standing outside of a spaceship. You probably don't know what that is. That just makes me a nerd. That's a replica of a police box from the 1950s in London. Basically, it's a spaceship from the show Doctor Who. So I'm showing you that I'm a bit of a nerd.
Really? Is that a Sean Connery one?
The Doctor Who series is a BBC series that started out, believe it or not, the week of when Kennedy was assassinated. And the show ended in 1987, and they brought it back in 2005.
No.
Sean Connery would have been an incredible doctor. Incredible. But it's a science fiction series, and in short, it's about an alien that he can regenerate himself whenever he dies, and when he regenerates himself, he is a whole new man that is capable of adapting to what he last died of, pretty much.
So, all right, you lost me there.
It's all right.
I don't do a lot of science fiction. Like, one of my favorite movies is The Highlander with Christopher Lambert.
Oh, that's the Highlander's great. Highlander's great.
When they went to Aliens and Highlander 2, they lost me.
Sometimes you just got to leave perfection alone. Sometimes you just got to leave things alone. Right. Yeah, I know what you mean. They lost me there. They lost me in the third one, and then the television series, it just got way too much.
Yeah.
But Highlander was great. The whole idea of it, these immortals are fighting to the end. They all have their own swords, their own training. You got Sean Connery. Remember, Sean Connery, he's supposed to be, which at the time when he presents himself to Christopher Lambert, he's supposed to be Spaniard. And Christopher Lambert calls him the Spanish peacock. You have a manners of a donkey, and you smell like a goat.
You stupid haggis.
Haggis? What's a haggis?
It's a sheepskin filled with meat.
It's revolting.
What are you doing with it? You eat it. That's revolting.
Let me get a shot at the flags. I need to show, you know. Need to show everyone how racist I am. Got the Gaston Culpepper. I need to fix that. Got the 1776 and the Florida state flag. So, yeah, I'm Cuban, but I guess I'm racist.
Yeah, this is bad.
So how much you think more is going to take there, Jay, as far as all these monuments being torn down and flags being changed? When does it end? Will there ever be an end to it? I mean, I noticed that two of the statues that were torn down or defaced, one of them was a guy, I believe, that was a poet, and he was completely against slavery. And they defaced his monument. And then there was another guy. I think it wasn't it Grant that they took his statue down. Didn't he fight in the Civil War against the Confederacy? Didn't he fight against the KKK? And they tear that statue down?
These people that are tearing down statues, they're wearing fucking T-shirts who have that Che motherfucker. Wasn't he a Venezuelan or some kind of shit?
Che Guevara was from Peru.
Right.
He was actually, a lot of people don't know this, he was a doctor. And I don't know what happened along the way, but he went from a lamb to a wolf overnight, literally. I mean, when you go to Africa, I think he went to Africa to train what they call rebels or whatever over there. It's like, man, I don't know. There are people that think that guy is a hero. His face, I don't want to say it's all over Cuba, but every time I see some type of documentary about Cuba or pictures of Cuba, for some reason, there's a huge mural of the guy. And a lot of people don't know. I remember once, it happened here in downtown West Palm Beach. Came across a kid, don't ask me how. I could tell that the kid was gay. He was wearing a Che Guevara shirt. I walk up to him and said, you know that guy used to shoot homosexuals for fun? That's no BS. Che Guevara used to shoot homosexuals for fun. And we got these guys, they're wearing his shirt like he was something great. I don't get it.
Well, liberals don't make sense.
It's upside down world. Or the Twilight Zone. Or 1984. Shit, we're almost in Road Warrior mode.
What about that scene in Smoking the Bandit when Bert shows up at Jerry Reed's house and he says, we're going to do it for the money. And he backs up the fucking Black Trans Am. You got to turn up the movie in that scene when Bert is backing the fucking Bandit out of the back of the semi. The sound of that car.
Don't go muddy, would you look at that? Honey, hush.
Now, you and I have talked about this before. I know a lot about the Smoking the Bandit behind the scenes.
They threw 455s in those cars.
Yes, exactly.
Nothing but engine, nothing but.
Those cars were not stock 400s. They all had 455s stuffed in them. And the stuntman union is the one who insisted on that, because they said, we're not doing these scenes with that stock 400. We're going to put our engine in that car.
which that turns out to be, isn't that like a 7.5?
Yes, exactly.
Because a car came with a 6.6. Yeah, that's a 7.5. Jesus Christ. That's nothing but engine. It's like a Corvette. It's nothing but engine.
Well, there's a great story. Do you know who the great rock and roll band The Who is?
Absolutely.
There's a great story about The Who. The Who was in town. I don't know what city they were in. But Keith Moon, the drummer, he was a notorious alcoholic, and he landed in America, and he said to his people, his handlers, because he was such a drunk, he had handlers.
He had to have babysitters.
And he said, take me to a dealership. I want the fastest American car they make. And they took him to a Pontiac dealership. And he bought a brand new Trans Am.
Probably wrecked it.
And he drove it into the goddamn swimming pool at the hotel where the band was.
Hey, watch this.
Right.
Oh, my God.
There may have been faster cars in the 60s. But in the 70s, there was nothing faster than a Pontiac Trans Am. Absolutely.
You know, all those cars back then, I loved all those cars, Jay. My mom's side of the family, she had two brothers, my uncles. They were motorheads. Now, they weren't in to the GM models or the Ford models. They were Mopar guys. I mean, I saw things that you're never going to see again, like dropping a monstrosity of an engine inside of an old small Dart with like a six pack.
440 six pack.
Oh my God. Again, there were things that I saw that we're never going to see again. You know, the whole transmission, the rear end, the bracers in the rear end and everything. You're never going to see cars on a street like that again. And yeah, they were doing them the GM cars as well.
Yeah, the 440 six-pack Mopar is one of my favorite engines.
My uncle, and if he's watching this, he'll appreciate this. My uncle Richard, I remember when he threw that Dart together. It was just, and he waited until late at night. It had nothing but straight headers. He hadn't installed any of the exhaust yet. And that car, it sounded like a rocket. Him just blazing down 6th Avenue, okay, in between I-95 and Congress and Lake Worth. Just going, you could hear him all the way down to Congress Avenue. That's how loud that damn car was in the middle of the night. And then shooting back, putting it up into underneath the tree in my grandparents' driveway, my mom's parents' driveway, turning it off and running into the house before the cops came or anything. Oh man, good times. I loved all those cars. I loved those times. Were you ever a fan of the movie Convoy?
Of course. Chris Christopherson. And that actress, what's her name?
She was hot for having short hair, and she was tan. And Jay, I know how much you love a brown eyed girl. Yeah, she was smoking. I forget her name. Ernest Borgnine was the bad guy sheriff. Oh man.
Yeah. I forget her name, but this girl I know, she said when they were kids they all cut their hair like her. I can't remember her name. There was the co-star with Christopherson in that movie Convoy. Allie,
Hold on.
Her name was Allie something.
Allie McGraw. As Melissa, yeah.
Allie McGraw played Melissa in that movie. Fuck yes.
Now remember, folks. Not only in Smokey and the Bandit was there a black hero, also in Convoy there was a black hero as well. The character's name was Spider Mike. You know, there was also people forget this as well. There's also an Asian hero in Smokey and the Bandit. When he comes out of nowhere after Frog went pond hopping. And, you know, the wrecker's there. They're gathering up all the remains. Here comes the sheriff. Yeah, Bandit went through here. Ain't he something? He ain't nothing. He's a mental case. And all of a sudden, here comes the Asian guy. Bunzai! And he takes out the door. And all that scene. Oh, that's one of the best scenes in the movie, if not the best. Yeah. Oh, man. And the cool thing for me about Smokey and the Bandit and movies like Smokey and the Bandit, Convoy, all these old movies. You know, I'm 46 years old. I've been watching these movies since I was a child. And as I got older and continuing watching these movies, I was picking up on things I didn't pick up before. And it just makes the movies even more entertaining, even more, just more funny. I love this shit. Sally Field had a great ass.
She had cute feet, too.
She was a little thing, man. Oh my God, a little. What do we call a little spinner?
Dude, I would even have fucked her in Forrest Gump.
Your mama sure believes your education is important.
Yeah, I've had a lifelong fascination with Sally Field.
Jay, did you watch episodes of The Flying Nun? Come clean now. You watched episodes of The Flying Nun, didn't you?
Yeah, as a kid, but I didn't find her sexy then. I found her sexy as she matured into a woman.
What? There was a movie. What movie was she in? I'm trying to remember. There's another movie that she was in after Burt Reynolds. What was the movie that she won the Academy Award and she's up there saying, "You love me, you really?" What movie was that?
Yeah, with all those other broads. She was the mom, and she was Steel Magnolias.
Yes, she was.
Yeah, Steel Magnolias. Are you kidding me? Every woman in that movie, I would like to have an orgy with.
Yeah, oh my God. And what's her name? I mean, they try to make her look ugly. What's her name? She was the real cranky old lady. Her son died in Vietnam. Oh man, Shirley MacLaine. They even tried to make Shirley MacLaine look ugly in that movie. There were times they couldn't pull that off. She even looked decent in that movie as well.
No. Steel Magnolias is a chick flick. But dude, man to man, I fucking love that movie.
So you've got Sally Field. You've got what's her name that played Erin Brockovich?
Yes. Daryl Hannah.
Daryl Hannah, Shirley MacLaine. Am I wrong? Was Dolly Parton in that movie?
Yeah.
Yeah, now I see what you mean by an orgy.
Dolly Parton is at the hair salon.
Yeah.
And that's when what's her name? She had the sugar attack. Remember? And they're ramming orange juice down her throat?
Yes.
Julia Roberts.
That's who it is, Julia Roberts.
Yes. Dude, Steel Magnolias has all my favorite women in it.
I wonder how this is going to translate to all the fans. We're talking about Steel Magnolias.
All right, I got 25 seconds left in this live. It's about to cut me off.
All right. God bless. Enjoy the rest of your night. You get back into town. We'll meet up. We'll have breakfast, lunch, dinner, whatever, all three. Doesn't matter. If Bradford wants me at his place, that's fine with me, too. You said you'd vouch for me.